Welcome to Columbia Catholic Ministry. Now, here's your weekly update from Father Dan O'Reilly.
I would be remiss if I were not to speak a little bit about St. Joseph while we're here at St. Joseph Seminary. May 1st is the Feast of St. Joseph the Worker. It was instituted to be sort of a Catholic celebration of May Day, which was the worker celebration in communism. St. Joseph was known to be a worker. He was a carpenter, a technician actually, a skilled worker whose labors enabled him to feed our Lord, to clothe our Lord, and to put a roof over his head. The Church has had a long-standing tradition of celebrating labor and human work because it is holy. It fulfills God's command to Adam to subdue the earth. So human beings reach their full dignity when they use their creative power to create and build things. So yes, I know it's time for final exams and final papers and lab reports and dissertations and theses, but that work is in fact holy. It is in fact holy when you're working in the lab, when you're cleaning your room, you're subduing the earth, you're doing holy things that God has blessed. So work is never supposed to be seen as a burden. It's supposed to be seen as a good, doing God's work, continuing God's work through our hands. In fact, were it not for work, we would not even have the Eucharist. Think of what the priest says during the preparation of the gifts. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Similarly, blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become for us our spiritual drink. Without the hands that pick the grain, without the hands that pick the grapes, without the hands that bake the bread or those that ferment the wine, without those that wrap it and bottle it and deliver it and send it and fill up the trucks with gasoline, without all of that human labor, we would not have the Eucharist to celebrate. So work leads us closer to Jesus Christ in the Eucharist. Human labor is also important to remember is not simply something for sale. Sometimes we think that we're selling our labor, but the Church is always reminded that human beings are the subject of their labor. They're never meant to be treated as objects. Human beings should have a right to work and should have the opportunity to work. So as we celebrate St. Joseph the Worker, we celebrate the creativity of all that we do in the classroom, in the lab, in the library, or even at home. All of the work that we do is holy, because whenever we do God's work, we continue the work of God to subdue the earth.